If you are new to the channel, then subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for further notification.
Okay, student, welcome you all to this new lecture in GATE machine series. So today again, we will be solving 5 questions starting from question number 16 to question number 20. Okay, then let's try to solve all these questions. Okay, in question number 16, an electric motor with the constant output power will have a torque speed characteristics in the form. So output power is mechanical output power, if I say, because they are asking torque. They are asking torque speed characteristics. So mechanical power output is torque into omega. Now if this is constant, then T into omega is some constant, some k. So you know the equation xy equal to c. What is the equation of this one? This is known as rectangular hyperbola. You can find in math section, in coordinate geometry, hyperbola section, you will find it in advanced course. I'll try to give a link. In that, I have described what is rectangular hyperbola, whose asymptotes are at 90 degrees. These are asymptotes. So this is your rectangular hyperbola, either this side or this side. Hyperbola, they have a two branch, this and this. Because we are not considering that negative portion, so we say this is the curve. This is one asymptote, this is one. These are at 90 degrees. If they are at 90 degrees, then we say that it is rectangular hyperbola. So it is known as rectangular hyperbola. That is your option D. Now if you come to 17, a 200 volt 2000 ampere RPM 10 ampere separately excited DC motor has an armature resistance. This rated DC voltage is applied to both armature and the field winding of the motor. If the armature draws 5 ampere from the source, what is the torque developed by the motor? Okay, it is separately excited, so phi is separate, so your torque is directly proportional to Ia. So whatever torque is in this case, so with the 5 ampere it will be half of that torque. So if I can calculate torque in the normal case, so normal case everything is given, V given, Ra given, I given, so you can find Eb, N given. So all things are rated values, so you can find its torque at 10 ampere. So if I calculate Eb at 10 ampere, so what is this V? 200 minus 10 into 2, so it is 180 volt. So your torque into omega is equal to 180 into current is 10. So your torque into omega is how much they have given? Speed 2000 into 2 pi divided by 60, which implies T is equal to 8.594 newton meter. Now this torque is for 10 ampere current, so torque is directly proportional to here. Phi is constant, so that's why I'm not writing phi 1 phi 2. Okay, let me write into Ia1 Ia2. So this is constant because this is separate, so it is directly proportional to Ia1 Ia2. So it is half of this one, you can say. For 10 ampere, if this is this much, so you can put it like this, T1 T2. For 10, this is, for 5, it is how much? So it will imply your T2 will be equal to half of that, that is 4.297 newton meter. Now if you come to 18, the DC series motor feed from a rated supply voltage is overloaded and its magnetic circuit is saturated. Now that means phi is saturated, phi cannot be increased further. The torque speed characteristics of this motor will be approximately represented by which curve of the figure? Torque speed characteristics of DC series motor. Normally, what is my torque in DC series motor? For any motor it is phi into I. And what is my Eb is directly proportional to, for speed I am writing, phi into N. Okay. Now this phi is constant here because this phi is saturated. Saturated means there is no change in phi now. You cannot change the phi further. It became constant. So you can remove this phi. So torque is directly proportional to Ia. And that means Eb is directly proportional to N. Now you need to build a relation between these two. So what is the relation between these two? V minus Ia Ra is equal to Eb. So instead of Eb, you can write it N into K, or Eb is equal to some proportionality constant NK. Torque is equal to some proportionality constant Ia into K2 or K1, anything. You can write K1, K2. So V minus, instead of Ia, you can write, so let me write K2 that side. So that is Ia equal to K2 into T into Ra. So K2 into tau Ra is another constant M. Suppose M into torque is equal to speed into K. Now you can say this is also constant, this is also constant. This, what does it look like? These two are variable. So it is sum of straight line equation, X and Y, simple X and Y equation. This is Y. Suppose T, if I write Y axis and speed I give my X axis. So T is given X, Y, this is Y. So it is some constant K minus M into X is equal to some constant C. V I am writing C, suppose Y into some constant another case. So it is an equation of X and Y, that is a linear equation. So which curve is the linear curve? That is DB curve, BD curve. So you can say its slope is also minus M by K. So it is also decreasing. So it's a descend, it's a straight line, which is the falling straight line, negative slope. That is your curve B, that is option B. Now if you come to 19, the speed torque characteristics of a DC motor and the control methods are suitable for the same are given respectively in list 1. Field control. Okay, so let us see one by one. So if I say field control, for field control I am doing, what can we, now if I say control, field control, armature control, that means I can reduce the, control means you cannot increase phi, you can reduce the phi, phi is maximum, phi is given, now you can control it, you can change this phi, that doesn't mean you can increase that phi. So controlling is on always, I can decrease it. Similarly, armature control also, I can decrease that current, that's it. This is for speed control, and for torque, this is the formula. Now one by one, if I'm thinking about speed, because this is the formula for speed, you have to take then torque constant one by one. If I'm considering for torque, then I will consider speed constant. I cannot change both at a time. So because one is for one purpose, so I will be using for one purpose. So if I take torque constant, so let me see what happens. If torque constant, that means your IA is constant. Now once your IA is constant, that means your EB is also constant. Why? Because V is constant, RA is constant, IA is constant, so EB is constant. So once your EB is constant, now you can say this is constant, this is constant. So if you change this one, it has to be increased. If this is constant, then these and these are inversely proportional. Phi 1 by phi 2 will be N2 by N1. So if you, this is increasing, then this will be decreasing. So if you are reducing, if you are controlling field, that means you are reducing phi, you can reduce your phi. That means you can increase your speed. So this phase control, it can be used for increasing speed, that is above base speed, field control. Now come to torque, the same field control. In torque, what we can do? For torque, what we will do, omega will take constant. Once omega becomes constant, then your EB becomes constant, because it is phi z np by 60a. So if you fix this constant, then your EB is constant. Once your EB is constant, then your IA becomes constant. Why? Because EB is equal to V minus IARA. This is constant, this is constant, this is constant. So obviously IA is constant. Now once IA becomes constant, now if you are reducing this one, that means your torque will also reduce. Now this is constant, so you remove this one, so it is directly proportional. If you reduce your phi by field control, that means your torque will be reduced. So the same method can be used for below rated torque or base torque. So by using field control, you can increase the speed or you can decrease the torque, either of these two. So if you see which option is there, for A, it should be above base speed or below torque. That means A can be linked with 2 or 4. So it is given A is linked with 2. So the either option B or C. Now that means next I have to go for armature control. Same story. So for armature control, again if I go for same method, for this field speed, I will take torque constant. That means IA constant. That means EB constant. Now you come to this side, because you are, now you cannot say anything about speed. Why? Because your speed is on this relation. You are not changing phi, you are changing torque constant, IA constant. So IA constant means you cannot do armature control here. So speed is nothing, it is not coming out anything conclusive from the armature control. So let's go to this side now. T1 by T2 is equal to phi1, phi2, IA1, IA2. So again, this one is, I will treat for torque, I am considering, so omega I will take constant, EB constant, IA constant. Now here IA constant doesn't make any sense, because IA constant, I am changing armature control, that means obviously I will be changing IA. So because I will be changing IA, so I don't think in that way now. You just directly say your phi becomes constant because you are not changing phi. So if you reduce your IA, torque is directly proportional to that one. So that means if you are in armature control, you will be reducing that current. So that's why you can say your torque is reduced. That means you are doing below base torque. Now it is not strictly saying, but this is the idea. If you go by this way, then that will be perfect. You take one constant for another one, then you can find some conclusions out of it. Because IA, naturally direct impact of IA will be on first on torque. Then it can change in speed also, because that will be negligible. Because if you change IA, then there will be change in EB. IAR drop will change, EB will change, which will directly again go to speed also. So there will be change. It is not that the speed will not change, speed will also change, but predominantly we will take this one, torque. Because you can see, if you are reducing IA, that means you are increasing your EB. EB increased, that means N is also increased. So it can be also for above base speed. So both these cases you are going for above base speeds, but here it is directly connected only with torque only, that is 2-4, because 2-3 or 2-4 I am confused, so that's why I am going for 2-4 this side. You can say if you change your IA, that means EB will also change. If you reduce this one, that means EB will increase. If your EB is increased because phi is constant, so speed will increase. So both these cases are above base speed and below base torque, that is your option B. Now if you come to 20, the conductor to conduct load test on a DC shunt motor, it is coupled to a generator which is identical to the motor. Field of the generator is also connected to the same supply source of the motor. The armature of the generator is connected to the load connected to a load resistance. The armature resistance is 0.02 per unit. The armature reaction mechanical losses can be neglected. With the rated voltage across the motor, the load resistance across the generator is adjusted to obtain rated armature current. The armature current is rated in both the generator motor, the per unit value of the load resistance. So this is the idea. This is your motor, this is your generator. So the generator field is also connected to the same supply. Same field is, you can think of same field is supplying both generator motor. And this is load. This is changed to introduce a current which is the rated current. So if I is if you, because everything is per unit, so voltage you can say I am supplying per unit, current also I am taking 1 per unit, and this armature resistance is also given 0.02 per unit. That means you can calculate this EB, and this EB, this side and this side, it will be same because it is mechanically coupled. They are rotating at same speed, identical. So the same speed, the back EMF that is generated here will also be generated here, same. So what is your EB? That is B minus IA is also 1.02, so it is 0.98. So from here, what is 0.98 is generated now, it is supplying current, but this current is also 1 per unit because it is rated armature current. So this load, suppose you don't know R, but this resistance you know, that is given point. So 0.98 will be passing through, this will supplying power to this and this, because now it is output, so it is not V minus, you can see it is V, E is supply. So EB divided by total resistance R plus this resistance, that should be equal to 1. So EB, you have calculated 0.9 and you put it there, you calculate R, that you will get 0.96. This is your option C.
If you like the video, then press the like button and please give your valuable comments in the comment section.